added us to see our location?
This guy added a bunch of added everybody to his action on the net.
Oh, the new player guy who's asking for help?
No. Oh yeah.
Broken axe. My money might be my stash, actually. You would never do anything to hurt me, right?
Why would I? Question mark, question mark, question mark.
Here. I'm gonna go ahead to my stash and see if I left my money there.
Are you taking these points? Dude, we tried to play the multiplayer, still being worked on card. There's another one of those military cars.
Where?
At the Riverside thing.
Near Riverside?
Yeah.
Hey, I need to sit down in the car.
Yo, everything's gonna be in the trunk.
Oh yeah, we're gonna make hella money right now. Earlier I only had like 10 trunk space. Now we're actually about to crank this shit out. Oh yeah, you can't right click over there, but you can just right click on this side of the map, click cut down tree, and then just walk over there and start cutting down those trees. How are you dead? What the fuck?
Suicide.
Why?
To go back to Riverside, because there's another military car over here that I want.
Ooh, you dropped free money! Place in wallet. I do like that he's trying to make himself look innocent.
Yeah, this is this.
Oh, Y3V's on.
What?
The Y3V guy from yesterday. He's on. Hey, while you're in Riverside, can you check that blue car for me and see if I left the money somewhere? Inky Pookie Bear.
You don't have any money in this.
Fuck. Could you go check my dead body over there? Maybe it's over there? Or that other guy with you might have taken it. I don't know. Let me know if you can get Carpentry 2 or Carpentry 3.
Books or the
yeah, of course the books, brother.
Would you like me to drive this police car back?
That would be appreciated. Yeah. I at least want to get the frame of my house up. Isn't building on water disabled by a mod? Will I not be able to make a pier? That would kind of suck.
deal with it.
Are you here yet?
Yeah, we're at the outpost.
We?
Yes. Yo, where are you at?
My Wi-Fi went out, so could you just... If you can find planks in the ground, could you put them in the car?
Everything's in your car. In the, should I put it in the blue car or the white truck?
The white truck. It's not a huge bed. We're still on 5 grand with the trunks already.
Yo, can we get that, can I get that pink slip?
Hola! Which pink slip? The pink slip car?
Yeah.
I have it stashed in the woods. I have it marked on my map, though. Can we take you to it?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on. Let's fucking find it. Oh, we could walk to it from here. I just need to... I have a lot of exertion. If you want, I can show you the map screenshot. You basically get to the, there's like a street sign indicating the turn, and then you just get off the road there.
Oh, I mean, can you just drive me to it? Can you just drive me to it? Please.
Oh, fuck! Dude, I'm losing so much health. Holy shit. Hold on, keep it there. Holy fuck, dude. Owie! That's 5 grand of planks right there. Could one of you go sell this at the outpost? I don't really care who. Here, come in here, come in here. The fuck? How do you take damage all the way over there?
Parts in this game are a little bit laggy.
I never
we're going to get another car that's stashed, and then we can go to the chest.
It's all 100 except the hood. Look. I'm parking on this side of the road, even though it's on the opposite.
How did you maneuver this into the woods?
I chopped down a single tree. And then from there, it was just maneuvering.
Can you maneuver it out of the woods?
In reverse? Yeah, probably. Let me check my map. No, it's a little more right. Oh, that tree's shaking. Fuck. Should be like right here. Yeah, it's right here. There we go.
Yep.
The method to maneuver through the forest is to enter the cut tree menu. Okay? The key should be in my key ring. Yeah. Here, let me turn it on. Here, you want me to maneuver it out?
Yes, please.
Hop in.
Dang it, this car is only two seats.
Are you seeing how I got it in here now?
Yeah.
Can you grab the blue car real quick? I have two keys. I can give you a key. I forgot what all I put in the trunk, actually. I'm pretty sure there's planks back here.
There's
still planks. Oh, yeah, there's a bunch of beer in there, too.
How much do planks sell for?
50 each, so 100 of them is 5K.
Oh,
I'm assuming they took the truck to go sell it. Or not. Okay, back on our grind we go. Here, come get a key. Come here. Wait. Here, put it in the glove box. Let me put it in the glove box! And then let me hop out.
You can't take any damage from cars.
There you go. What's up, MG? Wait, I think the saw's in there. Let me check. Hand axe is. Owie. I'm inside of it. Hey, Angie, can you help me with the trees? Can you please? Or one of you? Here. I'm gonna chop them. And I have a saw for you. Could you just saw them? Hold on, let me do the glitch. There's my hand axe. Could you buy me a good axe, by the way? While you're over there?
Sure.
Thank you. Oh fuck, it's not letting me right click anywhere now. There we go. Can those two hear me, by the way?
Yes.
Okay. If possible, can I get a G-Wagon out of this? Oh, it's like 20K, I think.
We need a four-person car, too.
We can go for 40K and get two G-Wagons. Actually, I don't know how much the G-Wagon is. I think the Jetta's 20K, and that's a four-seater. The dash elite in there. I think that's also a four seater. Hold up.
The dash elite is pretty cheap, isn't it?
It's 10k. It is a four seater and it's a sport car. It's very quiet. Here, we'll use our first 10k for a dash elite, and then we'll get another dash rancher. Because I want to have a dash rancher at like all times. You guys can take the old one. I mean, you guys could have it if you want it. I need to take that blue car when we're done with this, though, so that way I can stash that in the woods and use that as a stash.
Just take the dash rancher, too.
We only need one car. And she just said outpost and nothing else. Fucking all of them into planks because each plank is $50 to the outpost. And it's like 10k for pink slips. For the cheap car. And then you get it all 100s like the one over there. Wow, one of my axes broke.
Bringing back a real axe.
Oh, can you bring back a real saw or a second saw so we can get this shit sawed more fast? I'm chopping down trees faster than he can saw. None of these are going to my base. My base will be separate. That way you don't have to worry about it. Do you mean like another saw?
Yes.
Oh, peak. I have so much exertion right now, though. Could I sit in the truck?
Yeah.
So, are you guys basing in Louisville still? Or you need to move somewhere else?
I think Louisville.
I mean, you could go for, what's that place in between West Point and Louisville? Isn't it called, like, Valley Pit Station. Stop?
Valley Station.
Maybe, I think. You could try that. I think sleeping will make me recover faster. The trunk on the Dash Elite is only 45. Do you still want it at, or you want to go for the rancher?
We just need it to get places.
Yeah, and then take the Elite.
Did they say anything on the ticket?
Oh, let me check. Yes. I told them that I lost money, and they just said, that is easy money. I don't have a weed farm yet, bro.
So, what's gonna happen? Was it Ryu who said that?
Yeah, it was Ryu. Bifsky's on. Are they server 1? Yeah, they're server 1. They might respond. They weren't on earlier.
skill issue.
I'm just really pissed about my stats being fucked. I had like 4.5 foraging.
Really just picked up that long.
I didn't use any skill books that run. I really need a skill journal. If you can get me a skill journal, that's about all I need to be a happy man. Does anyone have the other saw?
I did.
I'll go sell these planks.
Just love more, don't do. I have more in my inventory.
Okay.
Why would you go sell them yet? There's still like over 100 more encumbrance in the corner.
Is there?
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm used to my other thing that can only carry like 30 planks at once. Yeah. Do I go back to cutting now?
Probably.
I could show you how to do the glitch so you can cut in the outpost territory if you want. We could build like a really big happy settlement right here and have everyone be friends and hold hands. In enough distance to the outpost where if we get attacked, we could just run into the safe zone like pussies. It's only $400 at the outpost. Dude has plans. If you want, let me sell and grab you one. Yeah, what is it?
What's that?
There we go. Now I can see where I'm cutting.
That's a good idea. I don't know what you're talking about. Okay.
That'd be pretty hype. I would join
That's
the chicken
pool.
Nah, I think you're just a hater, actually.
I mean, I've joined it.
The 6.1 or
who took away
SRTA
lights,
Magnum
bro?
Or SRTA Challenger or an SRTA Charger.
It
just doesn't matter. You can do
the
same thing for all of these. Now, okay. These engines made anywhere from 420 horsepower. Engine,
as long as I get to keep my good car.
But yeah, so if that's, you could do a Magnuson TVS 26 like this one. You could do a Pro
the
Charger
like
everybody else do, but for the love of God, do not
honestly,
add
we
a
can keep grinding until we get a bunch of cars.
6.1 liter. But yeah, as for a power adder, you have multiple choices. But first, I would like to say most of these supercharger kits, pro charger
here,
kits,
I know the Ranger has really good headlights, so I'm
injectors.
Gonna go grab it real quick.
So if that's the case, go get some Hellcat injectors along with a Hellcat fuel pump. And as far as your power
after
adder,
I break
you
my
can do like
first.
A Hellcat supercharger swap. You can do a, you can do a.
Oh yeah, the $500 axe like instantly takes down trees. It's nuts. Does anyone have a saw on them?
A little saw in my inventory.
Plug. I'm thirsty. Now I'm drunk. Right now. I thought that gets you sick. Here, can you see? We're out of axes, by the way. If you can get me the $500 axe.
I have one. So we just need to grind. We have 10,000 right now.
Yeah, we basically just need to grind. We could get like 100,000 in like 20 minutes, probably.
But what do we need that for?
There's an $80,000 armored car on there. We could totally get like a 4-seater G-Wagon. Actually, I think it's a 6-seater. And then we could armor it.
$50 for each point.
Oh, by the way, if we get jumped here, just run northwest and you'll be in a safe zone. The wagon comes armored? Okay. Okay. Let's not buy any cars, let's save up for a wagon. Let's do that. What do you think?
I already bought a, actually.
Okay. Sorry, we're out of axes, I can't really cut trees right now. With your carpentry, you should come place the walls on my house later. Is it broken? I have so much exertion, I have no idea how to get rid of it. If it's not broken, I'll take it. Okay. Oh, wait, that's the better axe. Hold on.
There's two of them.
Yeah! Chicken man gets to work! Oh, I have to do the glitch. Anyone else that wants to cut trees, what you do is you walk down here, and then right-click at, like, the bottom of your screen on a tree, and then click cut down tree, and then you can just walk up top left and just go cut down those trees instead. You can't really right-click in this area, but you can down there. That's how the glitch works.
So, that car is perfect to drive right now. What if I just drive one?
Which one? The Dash Elite?
Yeah.
I mean, it's yours. We're definitely gonna be, like, the richest people on the server for a bit. I don't think anyone else is doing it near an outpost. Oh, you're already on that one. Ooh, my maintenance went up again. Yeah, we're about to take out so many fucking trees. We're gonna need so many more saws. And by that, I mean two. We're definitely taking these down fast and they can be sawed. Can we make sure one person's getting, like, all the carpentry XP, though?
If you want multiple people someone, there's no way to have one person get all the carpentry XP.
Fuck. I'm gonna have to take a seat after this tree.
I mean... How much longer do you guys want to be in this court? Because it's getting really, really warm.
Dude, if you're not doing anything in the background, I could see that. Just do something in the background. I want to do this so we can get the fucking 80k car. Does that mean you can make the good walls?
Oh, you need seven for that.
Seven? Yeah, is it the one that you could just walk through?
Yeah. You need level 5 to make the second layer that you can't just walk through.
Hold on, I'm checking the wiki.
You did that, Keisha.
Carpentry 4 means you can make the wall that you can't jump through. But we should get the, yeah. We need to totally do that for my house.
Any updates on the ticket?
No. Nothing. Why is my exhaustion just not going down, dude? How do I make it go down?
Wait a while. Right click and hit sit on ground.
Plus, sitting in cars makes it go down faster. Hey, which cars come already armored?
Why wouldn't you just armor a car yourself?
Buying an already armored car seems pretty good.
Just lazy. I love you, might die of thirst at some point soon.
No longer exhausted.
I'm a good.
I don't have a saw. Yeah, I also need a saw. I don't have enough money for a saw.
I have a saw.
Are you at outpost?
Yeah.
Can we get two saws?
You want me to buy another saw?
Two of them.
I already have one.
That'll work, I guess. How many saws are we at right now? Or not sauce, how much money?
I have 10,000. Make that 13,000.
You want me to explain you the glitch? Here. This is a safe zone, so you can't cut here normally. You have to go down to the right, and then cut one of the trees down there. Right-click on one of the trees down far over there. Right-click it, click cut down tree, and then you have the little menu open, and you can just walk up here.
Stall is on the ground. I think we're gonna go the chest down. You guys wanna come? Uni, Edgy, you guys wanna go to chest down with us? Are you guys coming to chest time? Yes. It's you. Are you coming?
Me?
Just stand with us. Yeah, you too.
No.
Are you coming to Chest 10? Okay. Alright, get in.
Do I get to sell the rest of the shit?
Yeah. Oh, do you want my money real quick?
Money? Sure. Where are you? You good? The fuck? Gracias. Where'd you leave the saw at?
Oh, it's on the ground over there.
Alright. I'll keep grinding till I can get the Jetta for 20k. And hopefully that'll be a good enough car for us. We kind of want it for myself, but you guys need it more than me. There's fucking four of you.
I mean, not really. We have a lot of cars.
Yeah, I guess I'll keep it then. Shit, I could keep it and then fucking put all these planks in the truck and just take it then to the spot where I want to build.
Yeah.
You trust those two, right? I don't need to worry about them fucking...
Yeah, no.
Okay.
I mean, I think Angie will just forget it, probably.
I mean, they're welcome anytime I'm there. If they want to just come fucking chill out. Well, I don't give it to no one.
Really
or get follow.
Only in the location of the outpost. Location of your base.
Well, you know where my base is going to be, right? I showed you.
Thank you.
But when you're in street mode, it's kind of tame, and even some sport mode or track mode, it's
going to go up here and check this radio station out because people need to base over here.
If you're going to mod, let's say, your exhaust. Now, we know that these things come with an active exhaust system. So when you're in sport mode or track mode, it opens up and you can really hear this thing scream. But you go with HP tuner bypass cable. If you're going the route of HP tuners, it's about $300 to get the MPBI tuner. Keep that in mind. I'll try to get everything that we've done to this build so far. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. This is a 2018. Because this is a 2018, you do gotta jump through some more hurdles. You got your PCF, and this guy has to come from either HP or Diablo Sport. Comes unlocked, and then you install it. But here's the kicker. To use the MPVI2 from HP Tuners, or to use any Diablo Sport tuner product, you need a...
I'm blackballed right now.
If you're going the route of HP Tuners, it's about $300 to get the... buy credits to tune with that software, and then we've got Diablo Sport tuner. Now that one comes with a complete package of PCM swap and the tuner kit. And so whichever device that you go with, HP Tuners or Diablo Sport, you want to make sure that your tuner is using that software. So
does anyone have a watch? Because I don't, and I have no idea what time it is.
Have that conversation. We had to go through a series of OBD tools. We had was used for in your cluster. The next thing we got for the OBD is OBD Link, about $120. It's pretty much a Bluetooth adapter. It really depends on your year and also the Uconnect that you have. If it was used, if it's from a different year, if the owner actually had a Uconnect server. service, things like that, you're not going to get performance pages in your radio. You're only going to have it. Cluster. The next thing we got for the OBD is OBD Link. About $120. It's pretty much a Bluetooth adapter that just them so you don't throw a coat. So we had to go through a series of OBD tools. We have the taser. And it does unlock like performance pages, sport pages, just really depends on your year. And also the Uconnect that you have. If it was used, if it's from a different year, if the owner actually had a Uconnect service, things like that, you're not gonna get performance pages in your radio. You're only gonna have it in your cluster. The next thing we got for the OBD is OBD Link, about 120 bucks. It's pretty much a Bluetooth adapter that just lets you connect with another software wirelessly to your OBD and just make some factory changes. So I used Alpha OBD. I purchased that software for around 60 bucks for my laptop, and I always carry around. I have a dedicated laptop just for this car. And so you're gonna be able to change BCM controls, light controls. I mean, it's pretty much like the taser, except with the interface and that you can see everything you're doing and probably a little bit more than the taser. But the taser is user-friendly in which you just hit a couple buttons, get going. The next thing we can talk about now is the performance upgrades. We did the upper trailing and lower trailing arms, as well as the upper control arms. They're fully adjustable, and this is for when you're adding power like this, you just kind of want to start with supporting mods. What did we do as far as horsepower for this build? As you can see, it starts with this leg maker intake. It doesn't really add a whole lot of ponies. What it does is it doesn't restrict you. And it is a louder intake supposedly than your standard Hellcat or JLT, things like that. And then next up, your catch cam. Most guys argue whether or not this is good or bad for your build. I put it in there, we needed it, color matched it, good to go. The next smaller mod is the Fast XR ignition coils. Upgraded ignition coils and NGK spark plug is a good start for when you're modding your build. And obviously we have the Hellcat supercharger. That guy right there, usually you can see it online, use 2-3 grand, brand new around 4, but you do need other parts to get this to work for your 5-7 or 6-4 guys. You cannot just put this blower onto your car and call it. You need the adapter plates for your head. You also need upgraded fuel rails, upgraded injectors. You need an idler pulley, Hellcat idler pulley. We got a 265 upper pulley. We're about to do a cool lower damper soon, and we're gonna upgrade to a green belt soon, but these are other things that, you know, will support the power that you're doing. Sitting right under the blower is actually a cam. The whole cam kit, essentially from Comp Cams. We went with the forced induction stage 1. It's kind of suited for just this setup. Didn't get the push rods from them, but everything else, the springs, the shims, the phase limiter, the cam, all that. You also want to delete the MDS. So when you do something like this, 4-cylinder mode, goodbye. Your gas mileage, goodbye. You don't need it. And that leads us into our 180 thermostat. Just to keep things cool, guys, running a 180 thermostat. I have noticed my ECTs being around 180, 195. It just dumped as high as 212, but as soon as I hit the road again, back to that 185. Pretty consistent in that way. That's a pretty cool mod. We actually have Kooks long tube headers. You can get it from Kooks, you can get it from Stainless. Power, Stainless Works, anything. 1 7/8, they all do the same thing. After the headers, they came with a race cat from Kooks. Pretty cool. I like them. They're good. I did go straight pipe. So there's no cats. Catless setup, straight down pipe. And we go into the Flowmaster American Thunder, which is a 3-inch stainless steel pipe. Usually only has a mid muffler, no resonator. I deleted the mid muffler, so it is straight from the headers back. It does sound nasty. You probably can catch it on my Instagram. I do have a video of just some cold starts, and you can see it sounds pretty crazy. Coupling everything that you're doing with the 5.7, you know that this thing doesn't come with a limited slip. It's an open slip differential. And what that means is back here, there's a thing in between your axles called your differential, and that is what spins the wheels. Now, open diff only spins one wheel. This limited slip spins both. Putting the power to the ground is a lot more consistent. It's something that you more feel. With the parts, all everything that I mentioned, the whole kit and shebang, you're looking at around...
What the f-
for everything, customized, painted red, all that stuff. That doesn't cover labor, but why labor really doesn't matter is because different rate, different state, okay? Whether you get a deal, whether you do it yourself, those are all factors. So what can you expect when you get a 5.7 and you do what I did?
Take my limitations, I ain't had it in
19,969. They call me Mr. Moneybags. Because I'm rich. Speaking of certain unfortunacies, I'm about to die of thirst. Now, I'm wondering which car I should buy.
Just put my crap back. Me, I did buy this.
Holy fuck, we deforested. I haven't seen it in full daylight yet. It's kind of like what they're doing in Amazon. Oh my god. So, how much does weed sell for, and how good is it to just do a weed farm?
The
server's lagging, isn't it?
Yep.
Can you hear me? I can't start a car. Dude, I need to go get a drink! But I can't start my car! I need to go grab a drink from my house. I'm saying my house, but it's not really a house yet.
Presents is gone. Our zombies just like not spawning anymore for some reason.
I'm going all the way to the trailer park for a drink. Hey, man. The fuck? Oh, shit, yo. Yeah, that was not you guys.
It was not. I'll do that.
Okay, hold up.
Brand new around 4, but a spark plug is a good start for when you're the Hellcat supercharger. That guy right there, usually you can see it online. Use 2-3 grand, brand new around 4, but you do need other parts to get this to work for your 5, 7, or 6 floor guys. You cannot just put this blower onto your car and call it. You need the adapter plates for your head. You also need upgraded fuel rails, upgraded injectors. You need an idler pulley, Hellcat idler pulley. We got a 265 upper pulley. We're about to do a cool lower damper soon, and we're gonna upgrade to a green belt soon. But these are other things that, you know, will support the power that you're doing. Sitting right under the blower is actually a cam. The whole cam kit, essentially from Comp Cam MDS. So when you do something like this, 4-cylinder mode, goodbye. Your gas mileage, goodbye. You don't need it. And that leads us into our 180 thermostat. Just to keep things cool, guys, running a 180 thermostat. I have noticed my ECTs being around 180, 195. It just dumped as high as 212, but as soon as I hit the road again, back to that 180 starts. And you can see it sounds pretty.
We're back in third quarter planning. Adams is quarterbacking this project.
Have you checked your mirrors at all?
This is a 4-piston, and they use 18 inches all around.
It's 2 separate rolls, but it's they're both.
It doesn't look like it's a 20. And I gotta tell. Okay, so like this is like.
That's weak.
Which is my wheel to my guys.
Right. Hell yeah, we just stopped by Chicago.
They don't always.
How you got those,
the Mopar hood pins?
Yeah, hood pins.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's gonna keep the hood from going up?
Yeah, you ready?
Before I line you up.
Straight if I push you back, ain't
it? You said who?
Straight if I push you back, ain't
it? You said what?
Dude, your hairline is receding. I gotta push you back. But you're in safe hands, man. I'm gonna hit you with this nothing that can and caress it in. Bro, that towel was so hot, man. I don't know how he was standing. Let's lock in. It's time to come out that hoodie, but I do got manners, so let me fold my clothes. I'll rise for the slicer. Now let's get into it. Go to my right, his left. You know the rules. What you do on one side, you gotta do to the other. And stop playing me like I need the spray, because I don't. But he did want the enhancement, so at client request, I got that boy sliced and diced before and after enhancements. But if you got similar problems and located in or around Charlotte, North Carolina,
I'm literally shaking right now. Like, what the fuck?
Look, you don't gotta put your cup down. Hold on. Really? And holla at me if you need me. Maybe you shouldn't. Look, you don't gotta put your cup down. Hold on. Drink freely.
Listen, my fucking barber, yeah? Fucked up my hairline. Fuck it!
Wrong turn. one of these matchups, bro. Osama bin Laden.
Pablo, clear of
for his
Bad Bunny. Fuck out of here. Prince Kylie Jenner. Prince. Pot Smoke Barack Obama. Obama had that shit. I go cap. That nigga shit timeless. I go cap, bro. Floyd Mayweather, Lady Gaga. Lady Gaga's voice and music is amazing, but Floyd's like, Floyd got aura, bro. Pull up, let me see. Pull up. Yeah, I like these. Fools, good shit.